Dan from Uncle Pumpkin here. I'm here on, I believe, my third video of this series talking about the song Underwhelmed, which we are releasing February 5th. It'll be a single and a video. But I'm here basically to talk about, if you haven't seen the other two videos I did, I describe what the song is about. And it's basically me ranting against the production or overproduction that has been happening in pop music to the point where everything kind of sounds the same. It sounds like everything's kind of spit out of the same jello mold. And it's just not inspiring, you know, it's not a soul at all to my ears. And, you know, we can do better than that. So to counteract that negativity, I wanted to talk about bands that I think are doing it right. And bands that are out there right now and that are active. You may or may not have heard of these bands, but I want to share that. And I also want you guys to share with me any music that you think is worthy of this cause. And because I want to get a movement going here. I want to kind of get more awareness about this. I'm sure there's plenty of people that are aware of it. It's just a lot of times I think we just kind of deal with it. And we can do better than that, like I said. So let's, you know, let's get a movement going. Encourage the younger folks out there to make some good organic music and not have to fall into these patterns of overproducing, auto-tuning everything. You know, just making it good and organic like we used to. And on that topic, I want to talk about a band that I think is definitely worthy of that cause. They're called the Lickerish Quartet, and it's three guys from the band Jellyfish, which is this big cult power pop band from San Francisco in the 90s. Primarily the 90s is when they were big. They weren't that big because they were kind of eclipsed by the kind of grunge scene that happened. I think they just came out at the wrong time, unfortunately. But they're incredible, and everybody in that band, I think, has gone off to do something else interesting. So there's this kind of family tree that's kind of spread out. Three of those guys are in a Lickerish Quartet, so it's Roger Joseph Manning. He likes to go by now. He added Joseph. I always called him Roger Manning, the keyboardist and singer. Tim Smith, bass player. He also had a band called the Huma Jets. And Eric Dover, who was, he had a band with Roger called Imperial Drag, which is really awesome band as well. They didn't get the credit they deserved, like so many bands. They only put out one album, but it's really good. Look up Imperial Drag. It's kind of, I would say, if you mixed Led Zeppelin with The Sweet and maybe Cheap Trick, you would kind of get in that ballpark. It's really cool. It's kind of sort of old school, glammy, classic rock with good hooks and good grooves. So that's a great band to check out. But most recently, the Lickerish Quartet, and it's actually not spelled how the licorice candy is. It's spelled L-I-C-K-E-R-I-C-E, I believe. I can't do it in my head. You'll see it. Anyway, I'll have a link in the comments as usual. You can tell they're old school guys like me, and they would probably rather put out one album, but I think they realize how people consume music these days by the single or by the EP. So they've kind of been releasing bits from this session that they recorded this past year. And really good stuff. Definitely need to check out some of that. I wish I could play it for you, but I don't think YouTube will allow that. Like I said, there's this whole family tree of bands that have spawned from that. I'm trying to think of who I haven't mentioned yet. I guess Jason Faulkner. If we're talking about all the people that were in Jellyfish, Jason Faulkner was the first guitarist, and he went off to do one of my favorite albums ever under a band name called The Grays. Very obscure as well. It came out in, I want to say, 94. And it was with John Bryan and Buddy Judge and a drummer who I'm not familiar with. But those three guys were the songwriters. And that album is just the ultimate, if you could kind of imagine the Beatles where they left off when they broke up. If they had continued, they probably would have made an album that sounded like that in the 70s. I would say ELO was kind of in that ballpark as well, kind of picking up where they left off. But just great, great power pop, incredible guitar sounds, you know, very vintage sounds, but great. Even like lo-fi mixed with really nice sounds, just an incredible balance of production. So yeah, definitely check those guys out. And then Jason Faulkner went on to do several of his own solo albums. Check out all of these guys. Andy Sturmer was the other guy that I didn't mention. He was the lead singer of Jellyfish and the drummer. And he actually played standing up. It's kind of interesting. He kind of went off. He got a little disillusioned with the music business and produced several other bands. He produced a couple Japanese bands and I believe a Swedish band. And then he did some recording himself. It was a little bit more in the country direction, and he's written some soundtracks. But super talented guy. I think there was just too much talent in that band and probably too many cooks, and they couldn't all get along. But in any case, they all kind of went their own ways. And we have a lot of great music left in the path of all of that. So definitely check out the Lickerish Quartet. Like I say, it's 10 days away from the release of Underwhelmed. I'm going to have some more goodies like this. I'm going to talk about more music that you should check out. And again, please, in the comments, let me know what I should be checking out. Anything in this vein, or just any music that you think is good and organic and unique and not following trends of modern day. Because that's what I'm basically getting at. And that's pretty much it. I'm going to be posting more information related to our single and our upcoming EP. There will be a video and a single, like I said, for Underwhelmed. Then we're going to release another song called Advantages. And then we'll release the full four-song EP after that. So stick around. A whole lot of stuff going on. And let's keep good music alive. Let's keep rock and roll alive. And I hope to talk to you guys soon. Cheers. Yeah.